Morning guys, welcome back to the cave. What I'm doing today, I'm doing a bit of a repair job. I turned this vase, the wood turning club. I was doing a demo at the wood turning club. It's got a string pull effect on there, feathers. Wasn't happy with it. I thinned down the paint too much, so it didn't quite work. The ebonizing lacquer didn't quite work either. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to mount it on the back on the lathe. I'm going to return it, recolour it, except I'm going to use a bit of a different colouring technique this week. So you'll find out what that is when I get to it. I'll get it mounted on the lathe, I'll get the camera adjusted, and then we'll get to doing some turning. Right then, here we go. Turning at about just over 2000. I'm just going to reshape it, get it sanded down, get it coloured, and see how it goes. Also had a couple of cracks up at the top as well, so I couldn't actually remount it to get the bottom finished, so I've sorted that out as well. Very quickly sanded. So that's it sanded all the way to 600. So I'll just get some sand and sealer on there. I'm just using the Chestnut acrylic sand and sealer. Doesn't take that long to dry at all. I'm just going to knock that back with a Scotch brake pad. We'll get some ebonizing lacquer on there. Again, this is Chestnut's. Right, we'll just leave that to dry and take a few minutes for that to dry, then we'll come back. I'll remount it, I'll put a different chuck on and I'll mount it from the top of the vase so we can get some, I might just leave it this way, we'll get some colouring done once it's dry. Right then guys, it's all dried off and what I'm using are Chestnut iridescent paints. I'm using yellow, red and turquoise for this. So what I'm going to do is just place some paint onto the vase as carefully as I can. These always get flaming stuck. And now comes the fun part. I've got a balloon. And all I'm going to do is place the balloon on top of the paint and just squiggle it about. Like that. There we go. Right, for the ones round the bottom, I'll use a different colour blue. Obviously you can get different effects with the amount of paint you put on. Put far too much blue on there, but I'll live with that. So there we have it. Now I'm going to let that dry. I'll get the bottom finished off and sanded up. Then I'll take it in the house and do some photos. So I'll put some photos up at the end of the video. Let's just adjust the camera. Right, so that's today's video. Quite a wee enjoyable technique to try. You could embellish this even further, sort of make out the flowers and stick some stalks in and leaves in and things like that. But I'm just going to leave that one as it is. And I hope you've enjoyed it. Please like and share. Another mention of Maker Central, that's coming up the 11th and 12th of May at the NEC in Birmingham. It's going to be bigger and better than last year. Thousands of people are going to be going. So come along, meet all the YouTubers who you've probably been watching for years. There's loads of them going to be there. Jimmy DiResta's going to be there, I think Bobby Duke's coming across, Heath Knuckles, I'm not very sure if Izzy Swan's coming across. I think Carl and Robin Jacobson might be coming across. Loads of guys from the UK are going to be there as well. Steve Trudell, Glyn's going to be there. I think Terry Smart from Chestnut Products is going to be there as well. Loads of people are going to be there. It's going to be a great weekend. If you are going, even if you're not staying at the Hilton, pop along to the Hilton on Friday or Saturday night. It's usually a good time in the bar with all the guys. So I think that's me for today. So I'll get on, get this video done and get some photographs taken, and I'll see you the next time. Cheers, man.